Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this very special edition of the Cross Media Café, which we call Holland's Finest. First of all, this event is organized by Media Perspectives and the Sound and Vision, which is the Dutch Institute for Media Culture, and it's all about innovation. And just a few moments to think, why is media tech so important? The media industry is always in change, and it's always driven by technological developments. This is not something new, but what is new that sometimes now we think that all this innovation is driven by a few Silicon Valley actors, and that other countries are just following their lead. And to be honest, this is not true. A lot of the media innovation is taking place in the tech that is underlying the media landscape, and everybody is, you know, innovating. And a lot of this tech is coming from other countries, and the Netherlands is actually a very good one. Hilke Sprangers, welcome very much. I'm going to tell the audience first who you are. You used to be, until a year ago around, the CTO of Talpa, which is a big media company here in the Netherlands, of course. You were CIO of the year. And there was something interesting I spotted in your LinkedIn resume. You actually, years and years ago, graduated cum laude in computer science, so you have the computer science at the heart of your whole career. But before that, you did 2 years in art school.
Well, actually, after the graduation of my computer science study, I went to the art school, yes.
It's the other way around.
I graduated and I thought, let's do something
creative.
Completely different. So, yeah.
The more you start to think, okay, to bring those worlds together, you need to have both.
It's creativity and technology that drives engagement.
Interesting. First of all, we've been talking about tech and tech developments for media companies for an hour now. You have been looking at this from the perspective of the responsible person for tech in a media company.
Yeah.
From that point of view, what is the most important tech development taking place right now in the industry?
Yeah, well, first of all, let's talk about tech. First of all, I would like to say that the scarcest resource in the 21st century is attention, human attention. Of course, that's the main driver for engagement. And how do you create engagement? It's creativity and technology. Let's talk about the technology drivers. I would say as a first key technology factor, I would mention the VR and AR, basically extended reality, creating whole new worlds and whole new realities. Yeah. And if you go one stage further, I would call that new reality. And you can say the negative side of that is deepfakes, where we talked earlier about. But if you look at the flip side of new reality, the positive side, then you could say that is deep creativity, combination of creativity, deep learning, and to create. And the opportunity there is to remake the world according to your own imagination. Can you imagine that, for example, hey, you can have your own personal Forrest Gump video, or you and I, you will be Ginger and I will be Fred.
Yeah. Just take the stories and make them your own and combine. This is happening a little bit already.
We are at the start of that. And building upon that, of course, artificial intelligence is another one and very important key factor. And why is it so important? Because it's the next phase after digital transformation. We will see an intelligence transformation, which will be even bigger.
You have to tell me a little bit more. What is an intelligence transformation?
You have to put AI and intelligence in your whole value chain. From content creation to content production, content distribution, content engagement, all based on data and algorithms. And that will be a big shift in the coming decades.
That's a huge shift to describe. Yeah. And Talpa, being a more traditional media company in the sense that they have, you know, they focus on TV, but they also have lots of other services and companies below that. Because some of the development you describe is actually taking place already much more in the games world and, you know, where people already live in those other worlds to speak.
Yeah.
So how does it work when you're in a media company with all, you know, where these new assets are being created, but where it really happens is where the users outside of that company get the chance to play with it. What does it mean for your role as a CTO of a media company?
Yeah, well, the role as a CTO in a media company, I think first of all you have to recognize that strategy in the digital age is all about continuous innovation. That should be at the heart of your strategy. So as a CTO, you have to bring it as a strategic topic to the board and make sure that's part of your strategy. And then the next thing, which is basically more difficult, is to execute that. And how do you execute on continuous innovation? You cannot just sit back and say, oh, let the innovation happen now. So what you have to do is to build an innovation system as a CTO together with the business, of course. And an innovation system is basically a set of structures, of processes, of toolsets to foster innovation, to stimulate innovation, even to dictate innovation.
And what should I think about? Is that it's more than just a department for innovation?
Oh yeah,
I
mean, you should not have a department.
That doesn't work.
Huh? Everybody, it has to be in your innovate. So I'm talking about structures and tools that you can think of. Yeah, you have to have, for example, a very good trend radar. What's happening out there? You have to think about and define your own innovation appetite. The CFO is defining the risk appetite, and the CTO is defining the innovation appetite. You have to set up all kind of domains. Where do you want to play? Where do you want to win? Next to that, what are the tools? Are you going to do M&A? Do you have an accelerator? Do you have labs? And then in the end, of course, you have your agile teams to also work from the customer side to on incremental innovation. That whole comprises your innovation system in a company. Yeah.
So if you say media companies are basically driven by innovation, so all these companies should have such a system in place,
There's
still different flavors, right? So you could still say, okay, we want to work for new things with all kinds of startups, or we want to build everything ourselves. Or do you think any media company should do both? I mean, what is a media? There are different flavors of innovation.
There's different flavors, and personally, I believe in open innovation. And also as a Netherlands, in Holland, we have such a rich ecosystem with research, with universities, with the startups, the scale-ups, the incumbents, the creative agencies. We've all seen them today, actually.
Yeah.
And we have to work together on innovation. Yeah. We are too small to do it alone.
I mean, this is like a really big question of where this industry is going. The media industry, which is already a really broad and diverse industry, and the tech industry, which obviously are, you know, interlaced on all kinds of levels. But it does sometimes feel that the drivers are the big Silicon Valley-based tech-based companies. They're not tech companies anymore, but tech-based companies, who then buy in media to expand their platforms. So then the media is just a feature of the tech company. It's not even an industry on its own anymore. It's just part of, you know, I want to roll out Facebook, so I need content, so go. How do you see that development? Because it's pretty...
Well, first of all, I think many of those big tech companies started as a media company. Facebook, a social media company. Google as an information search company. You have TikTok as a user-generated company. But at the core, they say, we are a tech company. We build tech IP. We develop technology IP. And by doing that, they basically say, our business is technology and our technology is business. Yeah. And by having this technology IP, they can scale much more easy into other markets. And that's why you see all those blending markets, from media is blending with gaming, it's blending with e-commerce, and that's what they all now offer in the market. So I think that's also a lesson that we have to learn here, and we have to do as well. Create technology IP next to the content IP, which always stays important, of course.
Yeah. Okay, so back to the Netherlands, we should establish more technology IP. What are the barriers? Are there specific things we should do, the industry, everybody involved, that to further this idea?
Yeah, so first of all, the strength, I think, we have a lot of creativity here, a lot of, we have a lot of ecosystem potential as well. And I think another strength of the Netherlands and Europe as a whole is that we value privacy and ethics much more than the other continents, and that's a good point.
Yeah.
It also gives a lot of opportunities.
It's a feature.
And where can we, absolutely. And where can we improve? First of all, we have to work much more together and we have to consolidate. I think that in my estimation in Europe is that we have like 135 mini Facebooks, mini Googles and mini Amazons. 135. So let's combine them.
What easier said than done, but yes.
Absolutely, absolutely. But can you imagine if you would take, like for example, Bertelsmann, Sky, Zalando, Spotify and maybe Prosus into one company. You can absolutely be a competitor to Google, and that's only five of the 135.
You want to organize a dinner with five CEOs and say, guys,
I don't have that influence. I don't have that. But I think we should work. We have so much potential.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. You are now CTO for hire, so to speak. You work for different media companies. Having seen this and having observed this, don't you think like, okay, I now know this market, I know how it works, I'm going to start a company? Because my feeling is the CTO should not be advising the board, the CTO should be in the board.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Okay, we're waiting for that next company then.
Maybe.
Thank you very much for
this conversation. Thank you very much. Yeah.